This tutorial we will learn about tab and tab selector and how to apply tabs in a document. Okay, you can set tabs to get several lines of text indent properly. Without any tabs added, each press of the tab key moves the cursor along by 1 inch. Okay, so let's begin the tab. Before telling the how to select tabs, I want to tell you about the different type of tabs. Okay, as you can see here, this is a small indication. This indicates the tab format. It's look like L. Okay, so L symbol indicates the left tab, which moves the text right as you type, like this. Okay, and when we click once here, as you can see that it's flipped T, you can say. So this is center tab. It centers text according to the tab. Okay, and the next one is mirror L. I don't know what is it, but it's called right tab. Okay, moves text to the left as you type. And the next one is, this is a decimal tab, aligns decimal numbers using the decimal points. And the next one is, this is known as bar tab, I think. Yes, bar tab. It draws a vertical line of the document. Let's see the next one. Okay, this is the first line indent. Okay, it inserts the indent marker on the ruler and indents the first line of the text in a paragraph. And the next one is hanging indent. It inserts the hanging indent marker and indents all lines other than the first line. Okay, so that's all. Now it begin again. So we have studied about all type of tabs. Now we will see examples about these tabs. Okay, okay, so let's start. As you know that this is left tab, I don't think I need to explain about this left tab, because this is a default setting of Microsoft Office Word. Whenever we open a new document, it's a default setting that we write any document with the left tab, like okay. So let's see an example about the left tab. Just choose which tab you want to insert in your document. Okay, then click on the ruler once. Like here I have inserted a left tab. Click tab and you can see it's the text moves toward the right as we type. it will be more clear when we will use another tabs. Okay, the next tab we are going to use is the center. Just click here once and you will see the next tab. If you do not want to use center tab, then click once again and you will see the next, which is right tab. Okay, so we will select the center tab. As you can see that here it is a center tab, and then click on the ruler to insert center tab in your document. So as you can see here is a symbol of center tab. Then press tab and you will see, notice that it is the center text according to the tab. Okay. It means that we are writing our text as a center text. And the next one is right tab. So just see carefully which one you want to insert, which tab, type of tab you want to insert in your document. Then click on the ruler. Like here, I want to right tab. Press tab button, and you will notice that it moves text to the left as we type. So this is a right tab, and then the next one is decimal tab, isn't it? Yes, decimal tab. So just click on the ruler and press tab, and this is a decimal tab. Okay, press enter. Then the next tab is bar tab. Bar tab draws a vertical line. Okay, so here is our bar tab. As you can see, it draws a vertical line. Okay, then the next one is first line. Okay, then the next one is first line. Okay, and click here. Oops. Yeah, so this is the first line indent. It means that it insert the indent marker on the ruler and indents the first line of the text in a paragraph. Let me show you. So the first line start with this tab indent, this indent, and the next line start with this indent. Okay, and each time you press enter, it will be start with this first line indent. Okay, so this is the use of first line indent. This is mostly used when we write paragraph. Okay, and the next one is hanging indent. Okay, this is a hanging indent like this. As you can see that it start the first line with here and the next one is with here. So it basically insert the hanging indent marker and indents all line others than the first line. because this so this was the type of tab and indents which we have used in this tutorial. And the last thing is, if we want to remove the tabs, then what we will do, you just simply drag and drop. Like if I want to remove this left indent from my documents now, because I do not want to use this left indent in my documents now, so just simply left click and drag it here. Now I don't want to use this center tab, so simply left click and drag it here. Left click and drag it here. Left click and drag it here. So this is how you can remove your tabs . Okay, or for the indents you have to drag it over here . Okay. Thanks for watching this video.